As you see here, we have the descending aorta, and we have a balloon here. As you see, this is the blue one sitting in the descending, proximal descending aorta, just distal to the left subclavian artery. And you see he's here, it's inflated during diastole and deflated during systole. Because this balloon is sits in the descending aorta, it's called intra-aortic balloon pump, IABP. Usually this placed and handled completely by cardiology, and usually placed through the femoral artery all the way and sit the balloon in the proximal descending aorta. As you see, this balloon has two functions during diastole and during systole. During diastole, it inflates, and because of this inflation, this will increase or augment the diastolic pressure. And the main benefit of that, as all of you know, coronary perfusion happen on the left side, on the left ventricle, happens mainly during diastole, not during systole. While on the right ventricle, it happens on the both systole and diastole, because the pressure is not that high. That's why you won't see a balloon pump in the pulmonary artery. It's mainly, you only see it on the aorta, and that means it affects mainly the left ventricle, or directly the left ventricle. Because of this fact, the balloon pump will increase and augment coronary perfusion of the left ventricle. The other function, it deflates during systole, and that deflation creates a negative pressure or suction or vacuum effect, and this will decrease afterload, left ventricle afterload, and increase cardiac output. With these two effects in diastole and systole, you will see that this intra-aortic balloon pump mainly used when there is an acute coronary syndrome associated with cardiogenic shock, because simply it helps coronary perfusion and help decrease afterload and increase cardiac output. This machine is usually a temporary support that can stay for a few days, no longer than that, placed by a cardiology in the cath lab and removed by a cardiology in the cath lab as well, or sometimes in the ICU rooms, but mainly in the cath labs, and usually to help support the patient for a few days until his conditions hopefully improve. And if they don't improve, then they have to proceed to the next stage, which is an LVAD, which we'll talk about it shortly. If they improve, then they remove it. A few practical points. Do not try to intervene or troubleshoot this machine. If you get a call from the nurse about this machine, tell them to call the cardiologist or the cardiology team, because as an internal medicine resident or attending, we don't have enough experience really to handle that. The other point is, when you listen or try to do your cardiac exam, there is a button on the machine called pause. You pause the machine for a few seconds, listen to the heart, and then resume the machine. Because if you listen to the machine while you still have the balloon pump, you will hear a very loud murmur and you think, oh, I'm hearing something impressive. No, it's the machine. So that's the second point. Another important thing is, sometimes we need to know when we think the patient may benefit from that. And sometimes when I see the patient may benefit from that, I tell the cardiologist, hey, what do you think about using a balloon pump? And they say, oh yeah, you know, I kind of forgot about it, it's a good option, let's try it. Or they will say, no, I don't think it's a good option because this and this. So sometimes you can suggest it in a polite way and remind them about that option. when there is a balloon pump, you need to identify the chest x-ray and look at the position every day in case the cardiologist forgot, and if there is a malposition of the balloon pump. As you see here, we have a catheter coming from all the way from down from the femoral artery. See, just follow this green line, and here you see this, the tip here, this is the balloon. This is an intra-aortic balloon and in good position. So you need to every day look at the chest x-ray, make sure it's still in good position. And this is, seems a guy who just had CABG, because you see the sternotomy wires here, you see a Swan catheter here, and you see an ET tube here, vascular congestion, you know, hypoventilation, typical ICU x-ray.